Caroline Mangelsing, and I'm the creative director of Vinta Gallery. Vinta Gallery is a modern Filipiniana clothing brand, and it's incorporated in Canada, so it's a Canadian company, and I have partners here in the Philippines. The following that Vinta Gallery has is actually all over the US and Canada. It's amazing because then it's like all of these North American Filipinos have gathered together under our page and are just kind of so inspired by what I'm doing. So with globalization online, on the internet, and everybody has access to everything, there's more and more representation and kind of self-representation of people from different cultures. We're in a really good time to be able to do culturally inspired fashion. Community here in Toronto don't have access to the clothing. If you look at anywhere in North America, where can you find Filipiniana clothing, right? So I thought it was a perfect fit. When I started, I was yielding calls for Filipino costumes. I was always really inspired by vintage Filipiniana, like from the old movies back in the day here, and how everyone used to wear ternos and barongs for every occasion, and just like everyday fashion, everybody would rock a terno. And I just wanted to bring that back because there's so much potential for it to be on trend, to be current, and to just, you know, like, modernize the silhouette a little bit, and then you got this very Filipino modern fashion. When people look at my brand, I want them to associate it with high quality and craftsmanship. Each piece is made by Filipinos who are skilled artisans. Each garment is meticulously worked on. It's made here by four amazing women who have really amazing skills. And that's what makes what our offering is different. For me, my approach is tailoring and flattery, making sure that every piece is gonna flatter every body and that they can wear it with pride. Something that's wearable, something that's chic, something that's modern. When you're trying to start your own business, you just need to have grit. You just need to have the motivation to just keep going. And it's hard. I think that people get really scared and that fear stops them. Especially when you're an entrepreneur, you have to let that fear drive you. When we moved to Canada, all of a sudden, there was no people of color. It was just pure white people. I encountered a lot of racism and discrimination and feeling super isolated. You know, in college was when one of my teachers told me that I should go learn how to be Filipino. For me, that was when I started to dig for my identity, and it became this lifelong thing. And that's why everything that I've ever done creatively had to do with being Filipino. Being Filipino and having that as my identity has become the central inspiration to everything that I've done creatively in my life.